this chapter of Matthew, there was a lady who had been sick with a bleeding disorder for 12 years. She went to the best doctors, received the finest treatment, but her health continued to decline. One day she got word that Jesus was coming through her town. When she heard that, something came alive on the inside. She had so much coming against her, but she didn't focus on that. She knew it was her time for healing. Instead of giving up, she fought her way through the crowds and touched the hem of Jesus' garment. When she did, immediately, key word, immediately, she was made whole. I wonder how many other people were there like her in the same type of situation. They were sick, they were discouraged, they had trouble, but they just watched Jesus pass by. They let excuses keep them from their miracle. Family, don't let that be you. Don't let your circumstances keep you from reaching out to Jesus. It doesn't matter what's happened in your past, you got to just keep moving forward. God has destiny moments in store for you. You have to keep pressing, keep praising, keep praying, and keep believing. Like this woman, you've got to reach out to Jesus and know that God is faithful and he will meet your faith with his power. Amen. You've got to have strong faith so that he can meet your faith with his power. So that he can show up in your life and do the impossible. Yes. So that he can show up in your life and shift some things for you. So he can show up in your life and renew and refresh and recharge and restore and revive you. Immediately she was made whole. There are a lot of situations that we're going through that some of us been lingering in. There are a lot of situations that some of us been dealing with that we should have been through, that we should have been overcame, that we should have been made it out of. But we get too comfortable and too content where we are. And you gotta have strong faith so that when you call on the name of Jesus and he step into your room, things will change immediately. You gotta acknowledge and recognize who you are. You gotta acknowledge and recognize who has all power. You gotta acknowledge and recognize that Jesus is in the room. Things change when you call on that name. That everything you need, he's able to provide. That your healing is already done. Your deliverance is already done. Your restoration is already done. You have a strong faith that will get him attention. Because without faith, it's impossible to please God. So we gotta have strong faith so that when Jesus is in our presence, and when we go into his presence, things will change. I have strong faith so you don't miss out on your moment. As you press forward, no matter the obstacles, no matter how tough your situation is, no matter when you have times that you've fallen short of the glory of God, every single day of your life, know that when you rebuild your faith in Jesus, he'll rebuild your life. When you rebuild your faith in Jesus, he'll rebuild your life. This woman, think about it, this woman, she probably spent a lot of her money and energy on getting treatment for 12 years. She would have been left alone by her family because of her sickness. She would have continued to experience a lot of pain and suffering. It was as if she was on her monthly daily for 12 years. She could have lost all hope for her recovery. But one day she heard about Jesus and believed she could be healed. And anybody in here, anytime you go through something and you hear the name of Jesus, you hear about him. What he's able to do and who he is and what he's already done for you, right there should trigger your faith. To know that I can be healed, I can be delivered, I can be restored because of who God is. She knew she had to get in position and get ready for Jesus to pass by. So that she can touch the hem of his garment and receive, key word, immediate healing. What a great miracle. Immediate healing. Some of us are waiting on God, but God is waiting on us. And you got to get up and move. He ought to walk as if it's already done. Some of us are waiting to be blessed to be who God created us to be when you already are who He created you to be. All you got to do is walk in it. Some of us are frustrated, worrying, trying to figure out why things ain't changing. That's because you got to check your faith. You got to check, do I really know the Word of God? Matter of fact, I quote it, but do I really believe in the Word of God? Do I really believe that God can do exceedingly abundantly above? That when I call on the name of Jesus, because Mark 11:24 says that when you pray and you believe what you pray for, you shall receive it. So why are you frustrated? Why are you worrying? Why are you drowning in your emotions, in your feelings, in your situation when you can call on the name of Jesus and immediately things can change? She knew that by any means necessary, she had to get to the one who has all power. She made up in her mind that she was not going to miss her moment. And you got to make up in your mind that no matter what I'm going through, no matter what comes against me, no matter what the situation looks like, I'm not going to miss my moment. I'm not going to miss what God is doing in this season. I'm not going to miss all the way He's leading me. I'm not going to miss all of what He wants to do in my life. Don't miss your moment. No matter what, you got to press. Got to press towards the mark. God already has your victory set up. You just got to press towards it. Go confidently in the direction God is leading you in. Remember, God doesn't want us looking into our past, but to move on, staying focused, not letting nothing and no one interfere. Yes, it takes courage. It can be hard sometimes, but you got to keep pressing, keep praising, and keep praying. You got to keep pressing towards God. Keep praising His holy name. And keep praying until things change. Even after He show up, you got to keep pressing towards God. Keep praising His holy name. And keep praying until things get better. No matter what you're going through, understand, family, with God, greater days are still ahead. God's timing is not our timing. It takes courage to keep trying. It takes faith to see the other side. It takes one moment for everything to change. Sometimes He breaks us down to rock bottom so that He can build us back up. Sometimes we feel too unfit, unworthy, too low to call on the name of Jesus. To have the faith and the mindset that says, if I can just get a hold of Him. In other words, having the faith that if I can just get God's attention. If I can just call on the name of Jesus and just give God's attention. If I can have the faith that when I speak the word of God, angels are dispatched. If I can have the faith that when I call on the name of Jesus, I ain't got no fear. I ain't got no worry. I can walk in my victory. I can walk confidently. I can walk boldly because of who He is. Don't miss your moment. It's easy to quit something in a moment. But you will end up with regrets. When you struggle, let Jesus guide you. When all is good and your life is amazing, you ought to thank Him for all He has given you. Because He's given it to you and He can take it away. You got to be humble and try to see the bigger picture for the events and people in your life, because it's all part of something bigger. There's a lesson in everything we go through. There's a purpose and a reason for everything we go through. And you got to stay focused, because there's a lesson in every person you come across, every situation you go through, everything that happens in your life is a part of something bigger. Because where God needs you in life is always greater than where you've been. He's not going to leave you. He's not going to forsake you. He's not going to abandon you. He's not going to let you fail. But all you got to do is trust in the Lord and have faith that God is with you. Have faith that He's working it out.